tactical metrics, I wouldn't wash them away. They are critical to measure the health of marketing as well as the kind of programs that we're doing. So be it the MQL marketing qualified leads or the SQL sales qualified lead, even the MIO that we talk about, marketing influenced opportunities, those remain key and the base level of the checks that we do in terms of how each of the marketing programs and campaigns are performing in the market, whether we are being able to reach out to the relevant audience with a relevant offer, and then being able to actually draw an interest from the target group in terms of being able to generate leads and opportunities. Having said that, it is always about improving on the good things that we have. So looking at this information, not only from a perspective of leads, but also being able to look at how these leads are progressing through the sales cycle, through the customer's buying cycle, and then getting converted into real opportunities then that get closed and then go to revenue. That gives us the full life cycle of the marketing impact. So from a leads perspective, it's about generating the leads, nurturing the leads, engaging at the right time through our various sales channels with the customer, and then following that lead through even the bid cycle. In certain cases, we provide product as well as competitive and market insights even at the bid stage to then take it through to hopefully a win where a lead would actually get converted into revenue. That is the aspect of the sales lead cycle. There is also the other aspect of the investments that are going into generating these leads and then taking them through the buying cycle. We have recently created a program which we call the Marketing Data Sciences group within our organization. And what that is looking at is the ability to track how each marketing dollar is going to result in a business impact through the various tactics and the various programs and campaigns that we are running, and then be able to report it back in a meaningful way to the CMO to be able to then decide where we should invest moving forward our resources and our funds to be able to deliver the maximum business impact based upon the resources that we have at hand. So that area would then look at all of these aspects that I talked about in terms of the lead generation, qualification, and so on and so forth to revenue, as well as the various investments that we are making into the marketing engine, and then how is it that these are actually resulting into an overall business impact.